fact, the acting deputy director is here from the Inclusive Finance Advocacy Office. Under the BSP Circular 940950, the one that has fiduciary function would definitely be the banks. So FinTech will just be enabling those banks by providing the platform for them to extend their services to their to the mass market. So the one being regulated are the banks until now. But the platform that we have, that we provide to banks, are vetted by the BSP. So we are not regulated as an entity, as an institution, but all our platforms have been vetted and have been scrutinized and approved by the regulator for it to be used by the banks. So even before the banks, for example, make use of the technology that we provide them, they would still have to seek approval from the regulator, from the BSP, prior to them launching it. So for example, that's one aspect on savings. Now, the first thing that we launched was in lending, or digital lending, which we call Lender. And this was actually the first of its kind in the Philippines, where the regulator approved a platform that is based on cloud. Okay, so we're using AWS, Amazon Web Services. So we are using that. So first time that even banks have used it, in fact, through our facility. And from the time that we launched this in way back January 2015, the digital lending service we now have about 70 bank and non-bank partners under the digital lending service. We have now disbursed over close to 25 billion pesos. And 8 out of 10 borrowers were from the provinces. And the thing here is that that's why BSP loves us so much, because we are, you love us. So, kasi we are not, hindi kami pasaway, di ba? So in fact, we are trying to make use of we're leveraging on mobile technology and trying to provide that to the banks, because it would be very difficult for banks to cope up with technology, because it is capex-based proposition. Because if you allow banks to do it by themselves, it would take some time. Because just imagine, they have to invest heavily on capex, etc., and individually they have to do it by themselves. But in this case, we are leveraging on economies of scale. Because, and even at the end of the day, they would now be treated to the finest and the most advanced technology available in the market through this facility, without them having to provide capex investment, but only OPEX-based proposition. So that's why it's now over 70 banks and non-banks who signed up with us. So in fact, it used to be, 2 years ago, para kaming may ketong, no? Kasi when we talk to banks, they don't want to talk to us. I mean, we don't want to talk to fintechs, because fintechs are here to eat our lunch. So what I told them, we are not here to eat your lunch, but we are here to serve your lunch. Okay, so that's why they fell in love with us. So that's why they saw it, that we are not in any way getting their customers, but we are enhancing their services with their existing customers, because we don't have direct customers ourselves, because it will be servicing their respective clientele. So the thing here is that we fintechs are the ones providing the extension by which they could now provide stickiness among their existing clients, and also the avenue for them to increase the volume of new-to-bank clients. Because I told them, what I term financial symbiosis or finbiosis. We leverage on each other's strengths. The thing here is that, why are we even talking of the current volume of consumers right now in the banking world? You're only talking of 30% of the population. But there is so much opportunity that is the untapped market, which is 70% of the population. We are not eating the pie, but we are enlarging the pie. So that's the motivation that we have provided to the banks. And a good thing there is that for fintechs to thrive, you have to make sure that the champion among the banks should be no less than the chairman of the boards or the president CEOs of those banks. Otherwise, if you deal with the middle management, they'll kill you. They'll stop you, because they will feel threatened that you will take their jobs. But if the executive champion will be the chairman of the board, or even the present CEOs, then something will happen drastically in all these banks.